introduce you to three of my closest friends. And you know what I love about this is you just lay them out here, and even a five-year-old knows what these are because they're in cartoons and stuff, you know. And it is the three-shell game. I do this as a public service. Your mantra, because I don't want anyone losing any money on this, is really, it's really not good. Okay, in New York City, this is a one-act play. You're the star of the show. You're out of money. You're out of the show. That's the way this works. So your mantra, if you see anybody with three shells, don't play this. Don't play this for money. If you see anybody with three matchbox bottoms and a spit wad, don't play this for money. If you see anybody with three cards, don't play this for money. All together, low hushed tones.
Don't play this for money.
That's all I can hope for. All I can hope for. Now, people wonder where this comes from. It's actually these little guys. This is a scarab, the ancient god Capri. They're actually dung beetles. They're about this big. They don't look this good. Okay. Now, what happens is the female dung beetle lays a little egg sac in the camel dung. The male breaks it off and then rolls it around until they hatch, and then I think he dies or something. And that when you crack open those Egyptian tombs, there's thousands and thousands and thousands of these. Big ones, little ones, amulets, there's coffins, all kinds of things. Because in their creation legend, the ancient god Capri rolled the sun and created the universe. Of course, the guys building the pyramids cared as much as you do. They just used to bet on which one had the poop. Or the pee, depending on where you're coming from. All right, so where did these come from? They were discovered by Philistinian slaves under the watchful eyes of the pharaohs in ancient Egypt, 1700 BC. The secrets in these three shells were smuggled to our fair country in the bilges of one of the vessels of the Spanish Main. The bilges, vessel, Spanish Main. That's where all the poop in the ship goes. Okay. Mm-hmm. It's also where smugglers hide their contraband. Did you get the shells? No. I was hoping you got the shells. Anyway, the rebellious pirates who appropriated the game were eventually caught, beheaded by the king for revealing the forbidden secrets of the three shells. If we may, just a moment, silent prayer, and remembrance of our dear departed brother. Amen. This is how the game is played. Three shells and a pea. A pea is placed in one of the shells. There's a series of rapid hand manipulations faster than the human eye can follow. The pea is lost to the spectator's view. He's invited to wager $1 to the location of the pea. If he's correct, he wins $1. If he's incorrect, I love that. If he's incorrect, he loses $1. They're not prepared for the rapid hand manipulations of the operator or the speed with which the shells move about the demonstration surface. Tremendous disadvantage. Kat, where do you think it is?
Middle.
Good. Excellent. That was great. Give her a big hand. Woo! All right. Remember what that feels like. It's the last time, all right? Not because of anything, but I cheat. I mean, very, very good. You guys still want to play, though, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Here we go. Okay. And you want one? You're a good one. Okay. All right, here we go. And you get to take up the other one. All right. Here we go. All right. Ready, Brian?
I'm upset.
All right. Ryan. Right.
Yeah.
It's a crease in the hair. My mind slips. All right. Here we go. Justin. All right. Here we go. You ready, buddy?
Ready.
Good luck. Now, there's a couple things. Let me just real quick. No one touches the shells. No one touches the peas because of the women. Now, the women, see them. She's like this. She could care less. Women don't care about this. And then when they do play, they have to cheat. See, you know, they have lipstick on like this, and they go like this. Which one do you think it is? And they go, that one. They get a little red spot there. And they keep adding to it. That one, that one, that one, that one. And finally, they all look like this. Okay. No one cheats, but there'll be no lip licking without me. Okay. All right. Here we go. You ready, Justin?
Ready.
All right, here we go. Good luck, sir. Here we go. All right, are you on it? All right, here we go. Good luck, sir. Just set it down where you think it is. All right, I told you I was going to cheat. I was going to cheat. All right, this is what you said. Just so you know what it feels like, okay? And you were very nice. You took it very well. You took it very well. You were laughing a little bit. You know, okay, so 50-50 chance. Better odds than any casino in the world. Good luck, sir. Mm-hmm. All right. Actually, I think you got it. I think you got it, because I thought it was this one. Whoa! I'm sorry. Oh, who needs a hug? All right. Give him a hand. He's a good sport. Clean cut. He's a loser, but he was still good. All right, Kat, we're gonna take it up a notch.
Okay.
It won't be much, but I'll help you out as much as I can.
Okay.
All right, here we go. All right, she's watching like a hawk. All right, are you on it?
Sure.
All right, here we go. Here we go. All right. Good luck.
Seriously.
Okay. You looked at that one and you just put it there.
I don't know.
But you looked at that and then just put it there. Now we're going to get rid of this one, okay? Because I don't want you to like lose on that one and then you go back over here because that would be stupid. No. Okay, we don't want to do that. Okay. So you still want to stick with this one?
Yeah.
Okay, thanks for coming. Give her a nice big hand. She's good. She's good. Give her a nice big hand. She needs a hug.
Oh, okay.
I'm pressing her. Stepped on his foot, you know. Sorry, buddy. I meant to crush his heel. Okay. So, you ready?
I don't stand a chance, but yes.
Actually, I saved the kitchen sink for you. You're right. Okay, but we're going to do it everything, and I will coach you, help you any way that I possibly can. Any small or intermediate service I can be to you. Okay. Here we go. You ready?
Sure.
He's on it. All right. You ready? Here we go. Yes. Here we go. A lot of things going on here. Now watch this. Look it. Eh? And then I put my hands in my pocket. Everything's a bet. It's in your hand. It's in your pocket. There's no pee on the table. That's a bet. It's over here. Those are all bets. Everything's a bet. Good luck, sir.
All right. Let's go for the one that wasn't involved in the action.
Okay. All right. All right. That's fine. Put your finger on that one, and you're going to need another chip. what would be your second choice?
Sure.
With another chip. Yeah. Okay. Excellent. So this leaves me this one.
Okay.
All right. Let's see how you did. Oh, that was tough. Oh.
He's good.
All right. I gotta tell you, even I can't follow the thing. I tell you, I get lost with the. Oh, here it is over here. Okay. But I found if you slow it down just a little bit, kind of get into the zen of it, it can happen. It's here. And watch slow motion. It's gonna end up over here, Kat. Ready? Watch. Okay, now I know you don't believe me, but that's it. Let's do it full speed. Here we go. You ready? Watch this. Look at this. It got real quiet because everybody knows, you've seen it enough, it could be under any one of those shells. Mm-hmm. This is the first time it was where it's supposed to be. Yeah. Right. Now watch it. 80% speed. That's a 20% chance catching the little green pea running out and ending up over here. Ready? Here we go. Oh, that was a really good one. Your father's an accountant. He says there's only one way that you can win this. Don't play. Remember, don't play this for money. Okay. But what if it's a what if situation? What if the guy doesn't touch the shells, doesn't touch the pee, doesn't move them around, and then stands over here? I think he's got a chance.
Yeah.
I think he's got a chance. Okay. Turn them all down. Pick one if you would. Pick one of those. And then set it right over there. Okay, and then and pick up here. Pick another one. Okay, take that. Okay, and then set it right here if you want. No. Okay, and then put the pee right here if you want. All right, Kat, this one's for you. All right, here we go. Goes just like it's like your left hand. Put your left hand just like that. Don't press too hard because that thing will snap. And then straight up and straight down over the pee. All right, here we go, the box goes over. Magic proven. Okay, it's here. It's going to end up over here. Impossible. Be a good magic trick, yes?
Yes. Right. Yes. Okay.
As long as I don't touch it. But see, we're doing the gambling mode thing. If I just go like this, and then go like, see? Some little part of your pea brain thinks, maybe. It's already there. Am I right or am I right?
Is that over there?
Check it out. Lift it up so they can all see. Hey, you look. I love that.
Somehow that's a bigger magic.
Put
there.
Your finger right on top. Snap your finger. Can you do that? I love that one. Oh, that's good. Okay. Lift it up. I'll take the glass. There we go. Lift up the shell. Never let him see your pee. That's the first rule. Hey, look at the box. Look inside the box. The nooks, the crannies, the corners. And before you turn the shell over, one more time, everyone, all together, in low hushed tones. Don't play this for money. Thank you so much. Thank you. And let's give our spectators a nice big hand for helping. Yes! Woo!
What happened to the...
It's called... Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.